गुड मॉर्निंग मानशी, गुड मॉर्निंग।
हिस्ट्री और सिविक्स
बेटा, दिस इज हिस्ट्री, विल डू हिस्ट्री राइट?
ओके मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग कनिका। व्हाई अनन्या इज नॉट टेकिंग क्लासेस? अनन्या और अनन्या कनिका
मैम, शी इज देयर इन द मीटिंग
टुडे। शी इज देयर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
यस मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग, हाउ आर यू अनन्या?
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग अनन्या।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
यस,
यू आर नॉट डूइंग योर क्लासेस रेगुलरली? ऑल फाइन?
या मैम, नाउ इट्स फाइन। लाइक माय होल फैमिली वाज पॉजिटिव, सो आई वाज नॉट डूइंग इन बिटवीन रेगुलरली।
ओके, सो यू वर आल्सो पॉजिटिव?
हां, यस मैम।
हाउ इज एवरीवन नाउ?
Now, like, we are recovering, like, not completely, but we are in progress.
Okay, that's very good. That's really very good. Weakness must be there, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, do take care. Fine, I think more are coming. We'll continue with the history only. Fine?
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, Ujjwal, beta. Beta, hum log kahan par the kal? History में which part we were reading?
Ma'am, we have completed how participants saw them.
Okay, we have completed that. We need to start with the
limits of civil disobedience.
Limits of civil disobedience. That's really very good. Okay, give me a minute. I'll share the screen.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. Here we go. But I don't want to share this one. So beta, yesterday not every one of you had posted those questions. And Anshima, are you there, beta?
Yes, ma'am.
Few of the questions need little rectification, so I'll tell you that. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Can you all see the screen now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. Do we have any Harsh in the class right now in the meeting?
No, no, ma'am.
There is no Harsh. Fine.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, Rita. I think we were on this, right? Okay. We were on the limits of civil disobedience, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Hanji. Okay. Good morning, Pavni. Now, what is meant by this limits of civil disobedience? See, in this particular topic, we will be reading that who all were not active participants of the civil disobedience movement. Though it was a nationwide movement, but still there were some people, some group, social groups who were not part of this movement. Now, what were the reasons why they were not part of it? I think we all know about this. In the flowchart when we were reading, I told you that.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Can any one of you tell me?
Ma'am.
Yes, beta.
Ma'am, the limits of civil disobedience movement was that, as Gandhiji said, to boycott the foreign clothes and the imported clothes. So they were cheap. And if we used, like earlier they used khadi cloth, that was very expensive, so not all of them could afford them. And second, that as Gandhiji said, to not go to the government schools.
No. Nena, you are telling about non-cooperation. I am talking about civil disobedience.
Okay. Ma'am, for that, like... about the untouchables that many of Congress people said that untouchables should not take part.
See, it was that they, yes, beta, yes. Jo bolta hai, ma'am, may I to apna naam bhi bataya karo. Bacche, jab hum screen share karte hai, to aapke naam nahi aate. I need to scroll it down. Theek hai, haan, bolo.
And Dalits did not participate in the civil disobedience movement because the Congress did not give importance to their demands.
Mm-hmm.
And many Muslims did not participate in it. They thought that the Congress was moving close to the Hindu Mahasabha.
Okay. See, Congress, Dalits, those who were there, they were never told to be that they will not be the participants. Neither they had any demands, right? But because they were Dalits, that is why they were not even called for the participation. They were never asked to be part of it. So of course, a huge group, a good amount of number of people, they were not part of the civil disobedience. Now, these numbers which were there, they all were the untouchables. Now, because why they were not, part of it, because the Congress was not very much willing to make them part of the movement, right? This is one reason. Dalits, they never had any demands, but still they were, but because these people, those who were there, they were except for Gandhiji, nobody went to them that we want your participation. Or we want you people also to be part of these nationalist movements, right? So this was, this was something which was not said, which was not dealt with. So, but Gandhiji somehow felt that, their participation should also be there. Am I understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am. Yes,
second,
ma'am.
Second reason you said it was, Ashra is there in the class? Is Ashray there in the class?
Yes, ma'am.
Hanji. Bataiye, second reason. Muslims wala kya tha? Why Muslims were not active participants in civil disobedience?
From who?
Why Muslims were not part of the civil disobedience movement?
Ma'am, may I?
Yes, Gargi.
Ma'am, Muslims were not the part of civil disobedience movement because when the non-cooperation movement withdrew in like when the Khilafat movement was going on, the non-cooperation movement was withdrawn. So the Muslim sentiments were hurt and they were not able to trust Gandhi ji again.
Exactly. Very good, Gandhi. See, this was the only reason why Muslims were not active participants in the civil disobedience. Because we all know non-cooperation was along with Khilafat movement, non-cooperation was launched. But because this non-cooperation was called off in between, without fulfilling the purposes for which that movement was launched, and the Khilafat movement was still going on, but non-cooperation was called off. Though the reasons were known to everyone, but still the Muslim sentiments were heard, and the Muslims felt that maybe, you know, the Gandhiji was just trying to show that Hindus and Muslims are all together against the British rule. But then in somewhere, you know, they got this message that Gandhiji and other Congress members are not interested in supporting Muslims. So when civil disobedience was launched, they were not very active participants in it. I hope I am clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Let us have Gargi reading.
The limits of the civil disobedience movement. Not all social groups were removed by the abstract concept of Swaraj. One such group was the nation's untouchables, who from around the 1930s had begun to call themselves Dalit or oppressed. For long, the Congress had ignored the Dalits for fear of offending the Sanatanis, the conservative high caste Hindus. But Mahatma Gandhi declared that Swaraj would not come for 100 years if untouchability was not eliminated. He called the untouchables Harijan, or the children of God, organized Satyagraha to secure them entry into temples and access to public wells, tanks, roads and schools. He himself cleaned
Wait, tell me if the recording is going on.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. It's going on.
Fine.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Anji, beta.
Ma'am, I'm joining from another device. Kindly let me in.
Okay, beta. I'll take you. Beta, give me 2 minutes. I want to take attendance. Abhay is there in the class. Abhay Tomar. Is Abhay there in the class? No. Aiza?
Present, ma'am.
Akansha? She's not there. Ananya Singh?
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Apurva?
Present, ma'am.
Apurva, you were not there yesterday, right?
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
All fine?
Yes, ma'am. All fine.
Okay. Maybe you are tired of taking classes regularly, huh?
No, ma'am. Actually, I slept.
It's okay.
A bit more.
No problems. Aradhe? Aradhe kate?
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Ashray?
Present, ma'am.
Daksh?
Present, ma'am.
Gargi?
Present, ma'am.
Harsh Tomar?
Present, ma'am.
Himanshu?
Present, ma'am.
Jay? Jay is not there today. Jigyasa?
Present, ma'am.
Jujhar?
Present, ma'am.
Jigyasa, I'll send the answer today, bacha. Abhi iske baad I'll send you, theek hai? Kanika? Kanika?
Present, ma'am.
Manish? Manish.
Present, ma'am.
Manthan Patel.
Ma'am.
Beta, Manthan hai class mein? Nahi. Mohit Gangwar.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Mohit Kumar. Naina.
Present, ma'am.
Naman. Pavni, Pranjal,
present, ma'am.
Okay. Puneet?
Present, ma'am.
Raghav Raj?
I'm present.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Puneet is present. I have marked it. Samarth? Samarth?
Present, ma'am. Present, ma'am.
Shivanshi? Beta, is Shivanshi attending classes? Fine. Shaurya Shukla?
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Siddhant Yadav? Not there. Srishti Gautam?
Present, ma'am.
Stuti? Stuti Upadhyay? Not there. Tina? Tina, are you there, beta? नहीं है टीना भी नहीं है चलिए उज्जवल वीरेश वीरेश
प्रेजेंट मैम
भांशु
प्रेजेंट मैम
यश
प्रेजेंट मैम
एंड अंशिमा
प्रेजेंट मैम
यश एवरीथिंग फाइन एट होम बेटा
यस मैम
फाइन वेरी गुड चलो कैरी ऑन गार्गी He himself cleaned the toilets to dignify the work of the bhangi, the sweepers, and persuaded upper caste to change their heart and give up the sin of untouchability. But many Dalit leaders were keen on a different political solution to the problems of the community. They began organizing themselves, demanding reserved seats in educational institutions and a separate electorate that would choose Dalit members for legislative councils. Political empowerment, they believed, would resolve the problems of their disabilities. Dalit participation in the civil disobedience movement was therefore limited, particularly in the Maharashtra and Nagpur region, where their organization was quite strong. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who organized the Dalits into Depressed Classes Association in 1930, clashed with Mahatma Gandhi at the second roundtable conference by demanding separate electorates for Dalits. When the British government conceded Ambedkar's demand, Gandhiji began a fast unto death. He believed that separate electorates for Dalits would slow down the process of their integration into society. Ambedkar ultimately accepted Gandhiji's position, and the result was the Pune Pact of September 1932. It gave the depressed classes, later to be known as the scheduled caste, reserved seats in provincial and central legislative councils, but they were to be voted in by the general electorate. The Dalit movement, however, continued to be apprehensive of the Congress-led national movement. But anything in these two paragraphs to be explained in detail?
No.
Any of the line, any of the... Any of the sentence that is not clear or understood? Okay.
Fast and to death means, ma'am, Gandhiji was dead after this fast.
No. Fast and to death means he kept fast until Ambedkarji agreed to it or not to eat anything. Not to eat anything. Fast and to death ka matlab hota hai kuch bhi nahi khana. और जब तक जो भी जिस वजह से ये फास्ट रखा जा रहा है उस जैसे अंबेडकर जी को कन्विंस करने के लिए रखा गया था तो लोगों ने फिर उनको समझाया अंबेडकर जी को कि भाई दिस इज नॉट राइट वी नीड गांधी जी एंड इफ यू विल नॉट अग्री टू व्हाट ही इज सेइंग देन इट विल यू नो इट मे टेक हिज लाइफ सो काफी लंबे समय का फास्ट रखा था उन्होंने और फिर बहुत मुश्किल से जो है डॉक्टर बी आर अम्बेडकर को समझाया गया इस चीज को और अल्टीमेटली ही अग्रीड टू हिज कंडीशन तब जाके उन्होंने अपना फास्ट खोला फास्ट अनटू डेथ का मतलब होता है कुछ भी नहीं खाना कुछ लोग होते हैं ना पानी
नॉट ईटिंग टिल द वर्क इज नॉट डन
अनटिल द द टारगेट इज अचीव्ड ओके जैसे हम लोग जिद करते हैं मम्मी पापा से कि हमें ये सामान चाहिए वो सामान चाहिए आप हमें ऐसा कर दो कि वैसा कर दो होता है ना कई बार
Ma'am, like yes, hunger ma'am. Strike.
Hunger strike, exactly. It was a hunger strike. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, what was Pune Pact?
Beta, Pune Pact was the pact that was signed between Dr. B.R. Ambedkar agreed. No, see, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar had demanded in the second roundtable conference for the separate electorates. Separate electorates ka matlab kya hota hai, jante hain?
Yes, ma'am.
Ki sab kuch alag, matlab jo Dalits the, unke liye ek alag jo hai, इलेक्टोरेट बनेगा जहां पे केवल वही लोग पार्टिसिपेट कर पाएंगे इलेक्शंस में, वही लोग लड़ेंगे. जैसे मुस्लिम्स ने सेपरेट इलेक्टोरेट का डिमांड करा था, वैसे ही इन लोगों ने भी सेपरेट इलेक्टोरेट का डिमांड करा था. ठीक है, तो पूना पैक्ट में गांधी जी नेवर वांटेड कि भाई इस तरीके का कुछ सेपरेट इलेक्टोरेट वाला सिस्टम हो. रीजन बीइंग कि उन्हें लगा कि अगर अलग इलेक्टोरेट हो जाएंगे तो उसकी वजह से जो है अननेसेसरी क्या होगा, जो हमारा जो प्रोसेस है ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस वो स्लो डाउन हो जाएगा, क्योंकि भाई एक पूरा ग्रुप जो है अलग हो जाएगा उस चीज से. ठीक, तो गांधी जी ने बोला कि आप सेपरेट इलेक्टोरेट्स मत मांगो, बट हम आपको ये इंश्योर करते हैं कि जब कि हम आपको जो है रिजर्व्ड सीट्स दे देंगे. ठीक है, आज आप देखो आज की डेट में वी हैव रिजर्व्ड कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज एससी एसटी के लिए. तो गांधी जी पूना पैक्ट में ये इस चीज पे अग्रीमेंट हुआ था कि जब इंडिपेंडेंस मिल जाएगी तब जो है रिजर्व्ड कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज बनाई जाएंगी, और उससे पहले भी जो जितनी भी प्रोविंशियल गवर्नमेंट जो है उसमें, और आपका क्या बोलते हैं जो जनरल लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली और जो आपका प्रोविंशियल असेंबली काउंसिल्स हैं उनमें जो है इलेक्शन वो लड़ने की उनको परमिशन मिल जाए. ठीक है, और इंडिपेंडेंस के बाद क्या हुआ कि उनको सेपरेट उनको रिजर्व्ड कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज दी गई, बट उन रिजर्व्ड कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज में जनरल इलेक्टोरेट जो है वो इंक्लूडेड था. मतलब इसका मतलब क्या हुआ कि जो रिजर्व कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी है उसमें तो केवल दलित लड़ेंगे, बट वो लोग जनरल उसमें से भी कंटेस्ट कर सकते हैं इलेक्शंस. ठीक है,
ओके मैम.
चलिए, एनीथिंग एल्स?
No, ma'am.
Fine. चलो, let us have आश्रय. देखो आश्रय को पढ़ने दो. आश्रय पढ़ो बेटा.
Okay. Some of the Muslim political organization.
Read some of the Muslim political organizations. Beta, I am sharing the screen. You can always read from here.
In India, were also Lukewarm in their response to civil disobedience movement. After the decline of non-cooperation Khilafat movement, a large section of Muslims felt alienated from the Congress. From the mid-1920s, the Congress came to be more visibly associated with openly Hindu religious nationalist group called the Hindu Mahasabha. As relations between Hindu and Muslim worsened, each community organized religious processions with militant fervor, provoking Hindu-Muslim communal clashes and riots in various cities. Every riot deepened the distance between the two communities.
Yes. Anything else to be explained?
Ma'am, what is the meaning of militant forever?
Militancy क्या होती है बताओ? Militants कौन होते हैं?
No, militant forever.
वही हम पूछे militants कौन होते हैं? हाँ?
Soldiers? Maybe soldier.
No, they are not soldiers. Militant fervor का मतलब होता है कि भाई जो आपके ये जो militant groups जो होते हैं ये क्या होते हैं, ये दहशतगर्द होते हैं. इनका मकसद होता है दहशत फैलाना, डर फैलाना. ठीक है, तो militant जो processions निकलते थे religious processions वो बहुत intense होते थे. ठीक है, और किस उनकी इंटेंसिटी किस में बहुत ज्यादा हुआ करती थी, इन इन क्रिएटिंग टेरर अमंग द पीपल, ठीक है। फर्वर का मतलब होता है इंटेंस, इंटेंस फीलिंग होती है। तो बोले कि जो प्रोसेशंस निकलते थे इसमें, इन प्रोसेशंस में जो मिलिटेंट फीलिंग्स होती थी, जिसमें कि दहशत फैलाने का जो दहशत को हम इंग्लिश में क्या बोलेंगे,
टेररिस्ट,
नहीं टेररिस्ट तो अलग हो गए बेटा, मिलिटेंट मेरे को वो वर्ड याद नहीं आ रहा है, याद आएगा तो आई लेट यू नो, ठीक है, क्लियर? हाँ चलो नेक्स्ट, यश कैरी ऑन रीडिंग। यश,
यस मैम,
रीड।
The Congress and the Muslim League made efforts to
What happened?
The important difference were over the questions of representation in the future assemblies that were to be elected. Muhammad Ali Jinnah, one of the leaders of the Muslim League, was willing to give up the demand for separate electorates. If Muslims were assured reserved seats in the Central Assembly and representation in proportion to population in the Muslim-dominated provinces, Bengal and Punjab, negotiation over the question of representation continued, but all hopes of resolving the issue at the all parties conference in 1928 disappeared when M.R. Jaikar of the Hindu Mahasabha strongly opposed efforts at compromise.
ठीक है, anything in this to be explained?
No ma'am.
Fine. बेटा वायलेंट वायलेंट मेथड्स जो मिले, जो हम कह रहे थे ना दहशत, वो उसमें बेसिकली वायलेंटली जो है वायलेंट मेथड्स जो इन्वॉल्व करते हैं टू विद यू नो इंटेंस फीलिंग, राइट?
ओके मैम।
हाँ चलो, नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट पार्ट। चलो दक्ष रीड।
ओके मैम, मैम फ्रॉम
व्हेन द सिविल डिसोबीडियंस
मूवमेंट स्टार्टेड देयर वाज सच एन एटमॉस्फेयर ऑफ सस्पिशन एंड डिस्ट्रस्ट बिटवीन कम्युनिटीज alienated from the Congress, large section of Muslims could not respond to the call of a united struggle. Many Muslim leaders and intellectuals expressed their concern about the status of Muslim as a minority within India. They featured that the culture and identity of minority would be submerged under the domination of a Hindu majority.
Fine. Anything in this to be explained more? Class?
No ma'am.
No ma'am.
No ma'am.
Let us do one thing. Remaining time, we'll frame questions.
No ma'am.
Remaining time, we'll frame questions from these four paragraphs that we have read. Okay? And how many questions you will make? You will make approximately
20.
20 questions. Beta, mujhe kal wale questions bhi chahiye, all those who were there in the class. Right?
I'm sent, don't really send.
I know. Five only five or six have sent. This one also by evening you people send, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Thank you.
ma'am very short questions or ma'am like long questions?
Very, very short. That is completely your wish. If you want one word answers questions, you can do that. If you feel that you can frame a 3 marks question or a 5 mark question, that also you can do. Okay. But mostly in extract based questions, we don't give more than 1 marks for our questions. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Just share your PDFs after the class, okay? Not in between the class. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, the questions with answers.
Questions you prepare, answers you underline in the book only. I need the questions, okay? And from your PDFs only,
ma'am.
I'll be preparing question paper this time. Fine?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
from what is the meaning of apprehensive?
बेटा विरेश, एप्रीहेंसिव मीन्स एंग्शियस और एंग्शियस टू थिंक दैट समथिंग बैड इज गोइंग टू हैपन, राइट?
ओके मैम,
एक्सक्यूज मी मैम,
नैना
मैम, आई वांटेड टू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस लाइन दैट गांधी जी बिगन अ फास्ट अनटू डेथ.
इसका मतलब है कि गांधी जी ने फास्ट रखना फास्ट डिक्लेयर कर दिया कि मैं फास्ट रखूंगा.